Greetings, fellow things. Welcome back to the Silent Age. We are continuing on with the main story. I mean, there's nothing else to this game, to be honest, except for the main story. That is why you play this game in the first place. So it's a nice little indie game. Anyhow, without further dilly-dallying, we are about to address the chapter of the future in this video. And to that effect, well, I suppose we can start the chapter on what? Always, what like always gets me about this game is that even though the rest of the chapters are locked, the credits are still open, so you can like watch the credits any single time of it, anytime you want. Anyhow, the future, number two, chapter two, the future. After learning about Frank's sudden departure and getting promoted, drama unfolds as Joe finds a dying time traveler who asks him to save man from extinction. Now in police custody, Joe must make sense of it all. The dilemma. Anyhow, since, I mean, there's no breakpoint in between levels, it just rolls over into the next level. It sort of provides a sense of continuity to the game. Anyhow, I will of course be restarting the chapter, because that's just how it works. If you start the chapter, previous progress will be lost, all the locked chapters will still remain open. Of course I do.
Look. I don't want to be unreasonable here. All I want is some simple answers to some simple questions. Do you want this to become complicated, do you? Because, we can do that, you know. Make things complicated. Is that what you want?
No, sir.
Yeah, didn't think so. Let's just keep this nice and informal, shall we? See, I'm a simple, easygoing fella. I try to be affable and not go too hard on people. That's what I find works the best. Now, my partner over here, he's a different kind of guy. A real stickler for the rules. Ain't that right, Burke? See, I'm not too good with long, complicated answers. I confuse easily. Some kind of brain problem, I don't know. So, sometimes I gotta consult him, you know? In complicated matters, he's got a real talent for helping suspects simplify their statements. Thing is, he's not much of a people person, so most people seem to prefer dealing with me. So tell you what, I give you some simple questions, you feed me some simple answers, and we're all home before Donahue. How's that sound? Now, do you mind telling me what this is? Take your time.
The good cop, bad cop routine, huh? Time travel device. Now, I suppose the only way to get out of here at this point is... Well, I should think carefully about the next words I say to him. Intense police officer, the cop didn't introduce himself, but I can barely make out the name of it on his badge. It says F. Budkowski. I don't know for sure, but I have a hunch that door is locked. I'm not about to try. I hope the 10 pounds you gain on TV stays permanent, as scrawny guys like me don't last long in prison. I'm sure this isn't here for my protection. I hope someone is behind there watching. At least I'll have witnesses when they start beating the crap out of me. Then again, it probably won't make a difference. Anyhow, I suppose at this point the only thing we can do to escape the situation is use the time travel device. Where did the lights go? Hello? Was I just knocked out? I feel weird, like I was just folded flat and inflated again. Hello? That's actually a very good description of a journey through a wormhole or a black hole, which people theorize is supposed to take you, you know, is supposed to enable you to time travel, since matter and space compresses into one tiny little infinitesimally small point in space. You are supposed to be flattened and stretched out like basically spaghetti, and then once you exit it, you'll hopefully become whole again. We don't know. You don't honestly know whether you will that'll happen, or whether, you know, you'll essentially end up disintegrating into energy and coming out in the form of a pulsar. Anyhow, enough of a diversion there. Let's open the door. That's the only option we have at the moment. Ow, man, that's bright. We don't have anything else here. Of course, we can't use the time travel device again because it's solar powered. How convenient. The hallway. Not that I want to go back there again, though. Interrogation room. I don't see the point of going back in there.
Man.
I'm dizzy. What is this? What happened here? That should charge them. The guide said solar powered, so I guess that means I need to get it into the sunlight. Now, I thought I'm standing in the sunlight here, but I suppose not. Evidence room. It's locked. The evidence room is locked. I'm really confused. This doesn't look like a police station at all. Where did they take me? There are two stairs here. One goes upstairs, one goes downstairs. I suppose we'll check out the first floor first. What the fuck is that? It's locked. Of course it is. Hanging man. Oh god. What is this? I feel nauseous. I still don't have a clue what just happened. And now there's a dead body hanging from the ceiling. It's a nightmare. It's gotta be. No, here's the thing. I sort of want to be cautious about... Oh, there's a key attached to his belt. I should just grab it and hope it gets me out of here somehow. Then why don't you grab it? Whatever this key is for, I hope it takes me far away from here or wakes me up. This guy must have known what was coming. Either that or he was pushed. I can't tell which thought makes me feel worse. I have a feeling that there's a big gaping hole in the floor. I saw that. I sort of had a feeling that a hammer, they must have nailed that door up in a hurry. Pretty sure I can't exactly use the hammer on this door because it does not have a nail remover. Hammer doesn't have a claw to remove the nails, and the planks are too thick to break. There must be a better way out. Here's the thing, I'm still... Like, if I stand here in the sunlight, but... things aren't exactly working for me. I was hoping to...
No.
What am I, an animal? Yeah, I thought it wouldn't say too much. It's not a sledgehammer, true. That is true. Stairs to the ground floor, there's like a cockroach there. Should we check out the basement? Let's go ahead and check out the basement before we proceed upstairs. I only count three steps. The first two are fine. The third seems to be somewhere in the basement. Wait, there's a picture there. I wonder if that'll give us any clue. J. Edgar Hoover. That was, I think, another American president, was it not? I think, since it is yellow key, I'm not sure whether this works. It fits, I unlocked it. Well, I guess it does work that way. Evidence room. Oh, hey! Officer Burkowski. How do you know that? Because of his vest? I suppose. Oh god, I must be losing it. This police sighting. It's that officer from the interrogation, Burkowski. This is seriously creeping me out, man. Box evidence now. I want to get to that katana. However, there's a lock on the door. Greatest lock with a rusty old padlock. Maybe a hammer. Oh, come on. I can't even break a rusty old padlock with a hammer. I may be out of shape, but this is stupid. I mean, that's how it is, I suppose. I wonder if you have to scan the area or something. That door is still locked, of course. Oh, okay. That's Abraham Lincoln.
Far out.
There's safe hidden behind this. Far out, man. Lock safe, it's locked. What a drag. Now, there's a door here. The handle is broken off, of course it is. I suppose we drop the hanging man then. The door is tied in place. It's a rope the guy is hanging downstairs is hanging from. It's tying the door into place. Whose picture is this? It's Wyatt Earp. Good thing these things, these pictures have labels, or I would have never guessed. I suppose so. I don't know why I'm heading there. Oh. Okay, I just This might be totally far out, but what if the time travel guy was right? What if this weird box in my pocket actually took me out there, the future? I mean, think about it, Joe. What other possible explanations could there be? You're not dreaming, that's for damn sure. Head hurts too much. Well, I don't know. It's a big gaping hole in the floor. I could tell. I mean, I guess that's just the game being sarcastic. So, what we need to do is essentially find a way to... Can I, like, break the handle off or something? I need to get rid of the rope holding the door. The hammer won't do me much good here. Okay, the safe. Can the safe be opened with the brute force of a hammer? Then I wonder if that's where they keep top secret case stuff. Maybe confiscated money or drugs or confiscated drug money. What am I, Hercules? It's a safe. Crooks use dynamite to open these things, for Pete's sake. Thought as much. I'll never get through the door with this puny thing. Okay, fine, I get the point. It's a small hammer. Alright, so how do we get the bull guy off? Wait a minute. I don't think that'll work, but... Crap, it broke. Oh, hang on, I clicked. The door is open. This is just like on Dragnet. Yeah, I'm not really sure whether to be buzzed that it actually worked or appreciate the irony of breaking in using a police ID card. Now, here's the thing. Like, cards can be used to open doors like these. So, that's why I decided to try it. Oh, that must be the code for the safe there. There are some numbers scribbled on this. It's too short to be a phone number or license plate. Maybe the door code, a door code or something. 3956. One of the drawers unlocked. There's a bottle of gun oil in there. I suppose we can take that. Whoops, almost dropped it. The bottle's really greasy. There's a country map with spots all over it. I'm guessing that's it's a map of the country. It's riddled with pinned circles and notes that look like they were written in a hurry. Herman Bell, watched for murder. Possible connection to San Francisco 8. Now, I'm quite certain that... What was I certain about? Yeah, I forgot. Use code with locked safe. It worked! Oh, there's nothing in here but this dumb paperclip. What a bummer, man. Alright, back to the evidence room, I suppose. Now, this lubricant is probably gonna be used to not clean up a gun, but rather lubricate some kind of mechanism, I feel like. It's so stuck with rust. I'm only bending the paperclip. I need to lube it up. No wonder. Lock tumbler seems a little less stiff now.
Wow.
It's open. Wow. That was a lot easier than I thought it would be. I'm surprised as well. Open. It's a katana. Katana. I always get confused between opting for the American... way of saying it and the Asian way, but yeah, there's a katana that we have here and we can put that guy's soul to rest with this, if that's the way to put it, I suppose. Now the question is, do we use it here or do we use it up there?
Now.
Slashing a dead person with a sword? What happened to you, Joe? I sort of feel like that was an attack on me, but that was not what I was going for. Use katana with tied _rope_click_katana. I see.
Hi-ya!
The rope's been cut now. Gordian knot. Think like a samurai. That opens the door. Let's check it out before we head back downstairs. I have a feeling we might need to get there anyway. Okay, dead police officer, bookcase. Everything's in a mess, my god. Lots of dusty files and reports. Do we get anything from the dead officer? I wonder. I'm not sure I'll get used to this. I suppose... there's a big tree growing outside. I might be able to get out that way. But I'm quite certain that I'll need the rope for that, so let's go back and get the rope. I almost cut myself there. Is what he said. Alright, time to get the rope then. Where did the body go? Is it like all the way down to the... Oh my god, I need to go all the way to the first floor. Ground floor, rather. Just to get the body. The rope from the body, yes. I do. But there are no quick time events in this... They should come in handy. Yes, it will. But there are no quick time events in this game except for this one stage where speed is actually of importance. And... yeah, that's towards the end though, so we'll be able to essentially recognize it. I'll let you guys know about it when it happens. There's a wide ledge outside. I won't need the rope, of course. Would we need the rope here? Tree branch. Probably to get down from this tree, but whoa, that's really far down. Whatever that guy was feeling in that movie Vertigo, that's what I'm feeling right now. I wonder if the term vertigo started getting used because people watched the movie, or whether the movie was named after the condition of vertigo, wherein you get dizzy whenever you look down from heights. The most important knot I've tied in my life. That is not a good knot at all, so anyhow, let's hope it does not break. That was that for chapter 2. Not a terribly long chapter, actually. A pretty short chapter. We're still in the future at this point, and it seems that we will probably be in the future until at least the end of this chapter. The sun is still outside, but either the device hasn't charged yet, or maybe we need a place that is more sunny than this. So anyhow, this is it for chapter 2, the future. Thank you for tuning in, thank you for watching, and thank you for sticking around until the end. The next time we come back, we will be covering Chapter 3, The Machine. Until then, take care. Farewell, fellow things.